for him, and that, so he's in a very strange and difficult situation.
Do you think now that the divide's come down, do you think it's going to make things different for those two?
I think it'll make a huge difference, because I think they're a very emotionally turbulent, intimate couple, actually. And once that divide's down, I think the physical comfort and intimacy that they can share will help. It will help a lot.
All right, Joe, thank you very much.
Pleasure.
Give her a big round of applause, guys. One lady who hasn't let any of the house dramas drag her down is Kat. Just how does she manage to be so happy amongst all the madness? We thought we'd find out by spending a day in her life. Now, guys, there's some irony here. When she first went in the house, everybody said, God, she looks just like Nancy Lamb. Turns out Nancy Lamb's having such a bad one, she's ended up doing Kat impressions. Watch this.
In the morning, I get up and make breakfast for my Prince Charming. Simply toast and juice. Happy house, happy house, happy house. I watch the news and have tea and cookies. If I eat cookies, it makes me smile. When I married Prince Charming, our first dance will be do techno. No, 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 no. As it is summer, I like to work in my organic vegetables, flowers, garden. One day, I hope to have a cookie tree where all the cookies will be trees. In the afternoon, I go to work at the gym, massaging my clients. After work, I go out shopping. I'm so happy! Then I meet my friend Adam for a catch-up. We talk about old times.
Kat, do you remember those boots you was wearing? Those really big boots that you wore in the gym?
Yeah!
And you tried to go on a treadmill?
Yeah!
Yeah!
You like that shoe, didn't you? You wanted to wear mine? Oh. I won't let you.
In the evening, I have dinner with my sweetheart at my uncle's restaurant.
Hi, uncle.
Finally, my meal has come. I like sausages, but I don't like chipolatas.
Now, in a messy recreation of this week's Head of House Task, Emma and Dal have been recreating two London landmarks out of cake. Emma, it took Sir Christopher Wren 31 years to build St Paul's. How have you done in 11 minutes?
A masterpiece.
Really? Yeah. It's good, is it? No, you stay there, you stay there. Dal, the dome's roof weighs 4,500 tonnes alone. Have those guns come in handy today?
Yeah, it's obviously nothing for me, is it?
Really? Okay. Now, before we take a look at their masterpieces, let's remind ourselves how the housemates did. There's the dome. Oh, there's St Paul's. Yeah, look, well, that's pretty impressive, actually. And should we have a look at the dome? Less impressive. Shall we compare theirs, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, do you want to come round the back? Let's have a look. Wow. Wow, that's pretty good. It's quite a tough call. I tell you what, anybody who thinks Emma's is best, why don't you show me a red card? And those who think Dale's, give us a green, yeah?
Come on, those
Emma
green.
Emma red, Dale green. Green.
This is amazing. Of course he's going to win.
I think that goes to Dale, actually. But, but congratulations, because I feel sorry for Emma. I'm going to give it to Emma, all right? So, Emma.
Yay!
I'm going to tuck into some pools now, but join us after the break when we'll be giving Dale today's final challenge. See you in four. Welcome back, everybody. It's day 67. The time is now 12:39. Like Mikey and his peanut butter, Kat and her cookies, Rex and his princess, no Sunday BBLB would be complete without our resident critic, Grace Dent. Everybody, please give it up for her. How you doing,
Thank
darling?
You. I'm very well. You all right?
I'm very, very well. How's your week been? What have you seen for us?
I was going to start this week with Lisa.
Really? Okay.
Lisa's really grown on me over the last
few months. You and Emma, actually.
I know. I just love this kind of like gentle shades of nuttiness she shows every day. Whether it's like a tall tales or, you know, just every day she gives me a, oh my gosh, what has Lisa got on moment, which I really, really love.
Indeed.
So, I mean, at the moment, she's been, well, we've got a clip of her, haven't we?
We do. Let's have a look at this.
God, I used to wear some outfits. And I mean, proper power dressing, you know, the full hit, like knee-high boots, long PVC clothes, tight PVC catsuits. I was like a bit of a wild kid.
Yeah, Darnell was loving that story, yeah, wasn't
scintillating
he?
Scintillating stuff.
Absolutely.
It was for him.
I think the operative words were that I used to wear really mad clothes, yeah, as if she's just kind of blanking out the fact
no,
that
no, she's very conservative now.
Yeah, I know, with that kind of like Japanese rising sun headband and like, yeah, kind of the, you know, the top with the bit pulled out with like one boob making a bid for escape all the time.
I'm just glad she's not wearing full-on, you know, PVC catsuits anymore. That's all I can say.
And she says that with kind of like, you know, business wear almost, the way that, yeah, she describes it. Yeah. So bless
and
her.
And she doesn't just keep it to herself, though. She's
That's
sharing her tips, right?
Lisa is the gift that keeps on giving, and she's been helping Nicole with her hair this okay. week. But you know, at the same time, they should have been watching the sausages, shouldn't
okay.
they?
Let's have a look at this.
Who's looking after the sausages?
I am.
We need somebody in those sausages. They just need turned, Nicole.
Can you turn them?
Well, where's the knife? Why don't you get up off your ass and do something?
Because my hair's being done.
I'll just roll them like this. See, they're all sticking.
Mikey, bring them here. Mikey, bring them here, because otherwise they'll burn.
Mikey needs to get his priorities sorted out.
I know.
Yeah, fair enough, he is blind, and they're asking him to kind of put boiling hot oil in a vat and walk across, but Nicole...
She's getting her hair done,
Nicole's
guys.
Having her hair done, you know? So I think that Nicole, actually, I quite like her. I think
really?
That, well, I think yeah. that she deserves £100,000 for putting up with that odious little
twonk. Oh, here we go. Her. She's on one of her Rex rants
and
again.
And I just think that with Rex, I just think he treats her like this little special prize. Okay. Did you see his
we're
little...
We're not talking about Rex this week, are we? Come on,
well,
let's move
no,
on from it.
No, it's just last night with the sequins. When he's saying, has the sequins fallen off your dress because you've been out partying? I just think he's a bit weird.
Paranoid, I think you call it. Let's see our next clip, which I believe is also beauty related, yeah?
Yeah, yeah. I'm always interested in what the house brunettes do with their body hair during the time they're in the house, because if it was just me, I wouldn't want to have to do my moustache and my bikini line
okay.
and things.
Let's have a look at this.
Does it grow back quite quick at first?
No. It'll take about 3 weeks.
Yeah, that it looks awful. I don't like even looking at you doing that.
Girls have to do these things.
Stop having a mustache.
How? I was born with it.
See, if that was me, I just wouldn't do any of it. I would just let all the hair grow until when I came out on day 60.
Looking
I just
like said, a Yeti.
Like, exactly,
right,
like
okay.
that. But I like the way that Lisa's just went for the razor.
Yeah, yeah,
because
yeah,
it'll
yeah.
just grow back thicker and thicker until it's like nice, a little Victorian moustache.
I'm not yeah. a beauty therapist. I've got no formal training. But girls, if you're sitting at home, you've got a little bit of a tash, do not shave it. It's not going to be a pretty ending.
Yeah.
So, and then the next one you got for us, Rachel, your new heroine, right?
St. Rachel of Elstree.
Okay, oh, very good.
I
yes.
still want Rachel to win because I just think that, you know, she's continually upbeat, which isn't a characteristic that they're getting a bit rowdy, that I would be able to have. And I just love her kind of upbeat, positive attitude, even when she is given a really, really bad costume to
she
wear.
She still smiles
like,
all
look,
the way through.
I mean,
let's watch this. Right, there's this beautiful thing she's got, nice cupcake, and now she's stuck in the door. And she, oh, but she doesn't mind because she's a lovely girl. Most people cussing and swearing
yeah, absolutely.
Now. Squeezes through.
No tantrums.
Happy day,
just
she's all right about it.
And that's why she should win.
Yeah, do you reckon?
Absolutely.
What do we think, guys? Rachel to win? Not at all. Big round of applause
care.
For Grace Dent, everybody. Now, many of the housemates have been complaining about their single status. So last week, we asked you to get in touch if you fancied a date with any of them. Dale, surprisingly, has had quite a few entries. Two of the finest are here today, hoping for a date with him. He'll be meeting them in a minute. But with the events of Friday night, it may well have scuppered things for them. So, Dale, you get yeah. plenty of interest from girls, and yet you say you're not that confident with
nah,
them.
Nah, like, I don't... When I've been out and stuff like girls never come up to me, so I find it weird now that girls like speak to me and stuff.
Well, it's all going to change now, mate. Let's have a little look at what Dale had to say about ladies when he was in the house.
There's just like some pretty girls. Like, I don't know. There's just pretty girls. I've been stuttering all night, proper bumbling in conversations. I'm such a tool.
The thing is with me, I'm.